What measures would you like to what?
See, what we do is normally we make students sit down in the classrooms once the lectures are over, and we see to it that they sit and read and learn and write notes, and then they make them learn. That's what we do in our schools and colleges. It's not because nobody is interested in learning today, even in the, especially in the higher education. So we force them, once they come to the college, we force them to sit down and see that they learn. The teachers have been told that once the lecture is over, you take them to some rooms and make them read those chapters. That's what we do, forcibly. In fact, I have a school in Borivali, where international school is there actually, where we have IB and A-levels programs, and we do that this kind of teaching learning process possible. And last year, we had a world's topper in business studies from our institution, and we had toppers in physics and mathematics from our institutions in India. Two students were there who topped in India in IGCSE.
I think what your observation is very good. I grew up in reading books. There was a time when I had a collection of 14,000 books. Not that I read all of them, but the first book that I was introduced to by my uncle was used to get those Hindi translation of Russian books as a India-Russia treaty. And the first book that I read was Maxim Gorky's Mother. And I found it amazing, the reading process, because reading, as an actor, I think it's very important to read. As a person, it's very important to read because it expands your imagination. It gives you a visual treat. Whereas mobile, television, all these things narrows down your imagination, because you are seeing somebody else's point of view. On a dark, wintry night, it was drizzling, and there was this man with a hat standing under a lamppost. 100 people sitting here will have a different dark night. A lamppost will be different. Man with the hat will be different. But the moment you see the picturization of the same thing on television, it will be the same person for everybody. So I think that we should, the parents have to do that. I think parents need to tell their children to read books, because that will really make a difference. Yes, anybody else?
Parents have to sit with children.
Yes.
When they read, and then they will read.
They don't have time to stand with them. Where are you talking to them, sir, about that?
Anupam, sir, my name is Prabhat from APNS News Agency. The question to you is that, you know, education has been a thriving commercial business nowadays. And if you talk about education free of cost, that is of no quality. So for that purpose, what steps should be taken, and how can you prevent from that to improve the quality of education?
See, it's a very interesting question, and answer is also very simple, that free education has to be given by the government. Private education, you can make little profit, maybe 10, 15, 20% profit, because it has to sustain itself and you have to pay salary to the people. Therefore, the concept of free education has to be done by the government. And therefore, so what we do is we subsidize. Any poor students are there, we give them free education. Whoever can pay must pay. Subsidy is given to people who cannot. That's what we do in our schools. We have a lot of scholarship schemes, and we do give subsidy to people who cannot pay, and we give scholarships also. Am I answered to your question?
Yes, sir. And also, if you'd like to comment on this.
Major?
I have always got free education. I went to a government school. But I learned a lot more from my teacher's lifestyles than the books. I think we also, it's a very large debate. We can go on and on about it. I think the education system in India needs to be revisited. I think the children have to study something which they are interested in, rather than the same kind of subjects. And my niece and nephew, I pity them. Because in a 24 hours, if they sleep for 6 hours, rest of the time they are studying. They're there is no time to play, there is no time to do any extracurricular activities. You are constantly loaded with the, I hope your school does not give so much of homework, sir. I'll find out from a student. Yeah, because I think that's it's a system which needs to be changed. Because sometime a child is completely, if he's in our acting school, you will be surprised to know that 30% people come to my school after they have done what their parents wanted to them to do. And they include doctors, engineers, computer engineers, and then they say now lawyers, then they say now we've done what our parents wanted us to do, now we want to do something that we want to do. So it will get into a totally different debate about what should be done, but I think that's it. Anybody else?
We have a question from the gentleman. We'll be taking the last question. Yes, sir.
This question is actually for Dr. Pillai. Taking on from where Mr. Kher just spoke about, Ariman Raj. Okay, Dr. Pillai, like Anupam Kher sir said that today the load of studies on children has increased dramatically. Do you feel, or does your book actually talk about different options wherein other schools or other universities could pick up and actually formulate their educational programs into a different way?
I have a dedicated one chapter only for that.
Yeah, so you could just give us some tips on it.
Mentoring
so that
the arrival of the 21st century teacher.
Okay.
Okay, that's a chapter which gives you all these thoughts about how education can be made interesting for students in the schools, so that children will come to school. See, in fact, we have a school in Gorey where in which children will not go back home. They throughout the day they are in the school playing, doing activities and learning. So if we create environment like this, I suppose there will be a lot of change taking place.
No, but what happens is actually even the schools and the universities are bound by the curriculum which is set by the Ministry of Education. So they don't have a choice. They may just come up with alternatives wherein, you know, it makes things easier for the children.
See,
so from your perspective, are there any earth-shaking measures you've introduced which could actually...
Let me tell you, this is a secret. Okay. Though the government prescribes a syllabus, up to 10th standard, there is no terminal examination. It is done by the school. So it can be left to the school to create a curriculum mixing with the present curriculum and make things interesting. That's what we do.
Okay.
We follow the government pattern, but we mix things in such a way so that children learn, they are made to learn, and up to the 9th standard you can take the child. Terminal examination is only in the 10th you concentrate, 12th you concentrate. So therefore you can create interesting learning, teaching learning process up to 9th standard, follow the government syllabus, at the same time change it accordingly so that you can, so that's what we do.
Okay, thank you.
One of my uncles, he failed in 8th standard 7 times. So the principal promoted him to the 9th standard on compassionate grounds because the students started calling him uncle. But it was so funny that there was a different way of learning. Tables, I now speak tables at that time, 1 7 ones are 7 7 2. So he used to get stuck at 7 7 zar. Matlab Hindi mein unko pahade bolte hain. To saath ekam saath, aise wo yaad karte the. To teacher usko saath saath pe maarta tha. So it got, he got so used to it that even when he was alone, saath ekam seven, he used to sit and then only he used to do. So there are some novel ways of learning. Thank you so much. I think
just one moment.
Yes.
See, if you want your child to be very good in mathematics, first, second, and third, teach him tables up to 30. They will never fail in mathematics. Tables up to 30, 1 to 30, up to 30. They will never fail. We have made several experiments with so many schemes, like you know, good students in one division, bad students in another division, mixing, all kinds of experiments we have done in education. So therefore we have realized that the best, because maths and science is to be, you have to concentrate on maths and science. If you concentrate maths and science, your child will never be a failure. At least what is to be done in the schools.
Hi. Hello.
Okay. Yes. I hope. I believe you're not getting this humming.